Hi FlossTube, my name is Lydia and welcome to FlossTube number 16. Since this is my first video in 2020, I wish you all a very happy new year, with lots of stitchy time of course. This is a channel about cross stitch. I don't know if you have ever watched my videos before or that you are thinking, where is she going to talk about cross stitch? First of all, before I start, I really want to thank all my new followers. I have received so many new followers in the past couple of months, actually since Dutchmania. So thank you. It's so appreciated. And I love reading all the comments. I try to respond as soon as possible when you leave me a message. So thank you. If you haven't been following me, you can push the button and then you will get notifications when I upload a new video. You all know how it works, right? So this will be a normal update now. My latest video was a whip parade and now I will do a normal update. I'm going to do it a little bit around, turned around than I normally would. Normally I will start with whips and continue with haul, etc. This time I will start with haul, and that has a reason, because I bought something which I immediately started and finished, and then fully finished. So I'm starting with haul, and then we will end this video with some whips. First of all, I joined the WIPCO Facebook group. I was looking for something. I really like the acrostics, and I still participate in that, but I was looking for something else. And I, even though I like seeing other people's updates about enchanted stitches or magical stitches, I don't really like to do that, because I have read Harry Potter, but I don't know every single phrase of it anymore. So I wanted to participate in something a little easier, and then I found out about WIPCO, and I immediately joined. I really like it. So you will see two projects later on for January, and of course I am still participating for the January acrostic. Yes. So you will see a little bit of that, but since it's only halfway through January, you will only see half of it. I can show you a little bit of my acrostic page. This is my little notebook, and this I fill in January acrostic. I know you can print out pages, but I like doing it this way. It saves trees. I already have this notebook, so the words for this month are ready. Ready, set, XS, ready, set, cross stitch. I already filled in some of it, and I still have to fill in the both E's. I don't know what to do yet with that. I have some ideas in my mind, but they will come along through the month. Another thing I am doing, this is mostly for myself, and it's very bright on camera, I see. I want to finish my Fall Fairy this year, and in order to finish my Fall Fairy I have to stitch 275 stitches a day, which is quite a lot, I know. If I don't manage to get that, no problem, I will finish it in 2021. But it is a goal and I hope to reach it. As you can see, today is the 17th and I'm 2 days up front. Is that how you say it? So, yay for that. If I finish this month before the end of the month, I get to do a little less stitches for the next month, because I want to continue working on it every day for as long as I feel the need to do it. Okay, now we are going into a little bit of haul. I wanted to start with the mystery stitch along by Linen and Threads. I ordered some threads for it by Silks for You. This is PR144, and I hope it's showing up a little bit. Maybe I put something behind it, which isn't as orange as my dress. I don't know if the color is showing up very bright, but when I start it, I will post a pic on my Insta page so you can see the colors. It's PR144, so you can also try and look it up in her Etsy shop. And I wanted to start it today. I received this hank today, but then my fabric was too small. I was a little bit bummed, so I ordered some fabric, and now I have to wait a couple of days. It's not a big problem, but when you're feeling itchy to start something new, it's a bit of a bummer you can't start yet. But okay, then my next haul is something. In my previous video I talked a little bit about the things I received from Michelle McGraw, which contained a lot of Lizzie Kate patterns, and I really, really, really love them. I like the way the patterns are of Lizzie Kate. I like the fun features. And then I wanted to look around and see if I can order patterns somewhere else, because I have more on my wish list. And someone gave me the tip, 123 Stitch, Casa Senina has them. The webshop in England, and I am forgetting the name. If you want to know, please send me a message, I will look it up. They all carry Lizzie Kate patterns. Unfortunately, here in the Netherlands, it is hard to get Lizzie Kate. Some shops have a few patterns, but that's it. And I hope in about a month there will be a craft fair, the Handwerkbeurs, in the Netherlands, and I hope they have some Lizzie Kate there. But for the time being, I have been looking around to see where I can buy these, because I really like to watch Erin Tumantini Stitcher, and she is stitching the Lizzie Kate yearbooks, and I love to see them, and I love the way she finishes it. I'm doing it a little bit different, but I really wanted to do them also. And so I was looking around and I found them at Casa Senina. Excuse me. And I ordered January and February. Every year it's called, are they called Flippets? oh, double flip. And here you can see a big picture of January. And this is February. And then I also ordered March and April. And then as we are going on, I will order the other months, of course. So I really loved it because I have to check. In the I can't show it on the pattern because you will see the pattern. But in every pattern there is a little baggie with the beads you put on. So I really like that. You don't have to buy the charms or the beads or. So I started with January because I received them on the 8th of January, and I wanted to stitch it right away. I really loved it, so I stitched it, and this morning I FFO'd it. Yay! Here is January. I stitched it on a 30 count light blue even weave I got as a gift. So I don't know where it's from, but it's just plain simple light blue even weave. And I'm not going to stitch every month on this, but I thought, well, January is a cold month and blue is a cold color. So I really liked it. I really liked how the colors popped up. I only substituted one color, and that's the green in the trees, and it asked for, let me check, it called for 731, and I stitched it in all the color 4 DMCs, but it called for 731 and I stitched it in 368 because it was sold out in the shop where I bought the DMC. So, but I think I did a nice job with this. So this will be displayed in my house, and I removed the glass. The frame is from IKEA, which I had lying around for several years, so that I don't know if you can still get it. It's got a, see, it's not all flat. I removed the glass because then you see the stitches and the charming a little bit better. And this is how I can display it in my house. I think I will put those up in my downstairs toilet, but I might even put them in my living room. I don't know yet. But it's cute. Okay, well, that was my haul and my first FFO. And then I have a second FFO. If you follow me on Instagram, you might have noticed I finished Klein Paradijs by Joke Trebbe den IJs, which was one of the two projects on my Wipco board. And I finished it into a little cushion, a little pillow. I stitched it, I bought it as a kit, so I stitched it on the linen that was provided with the kit and the threads that was provided with the kit. And before I started stitching, I tea-dyed the fabric with tea that is turning up really pink. I dyed it a little bit, and I added bow on top with a bead that you can also buy as a needle minder in my Etsy shop, but it is also possible to use it as decoration on a pillow if you would like to do something similar. Then you can also, if you like, send me a message and I can always just sell you the button if you like it. This wasn't the way I wanted to finish it. I wanted to finish it without the bow and the button, but this was my first time finishing it into a little pillow. The backing fabric looks like this. Actually, these three sides look pretty neat, I must say. I did it on my sewing machine. You know what I mean, right? But I'm a beginner and I did something wrong. Instead of leaving the bottom open, I left the top open. And I did a horrible job at closing the gap where you put the filling in. So when it was standing on my dresser here in my living room, every time I looked at it, I was like, oh. I love the stitching, I love everything about it, but I hated the top. So I had to do something about it. That is the reason I added the bow. My mother doesn't like it. I don't know if I like it. It's okay, I guess. It's the first time I finished something like this. The backing fabric is from the Action, which is a store similar like, well, they have all kind of artsy stuff, craft stuff, and they have fabrics. Very cheap, so I liked it. So it's my second FFO of this year. So I had a goal to finish 20 projects in 2020. So I'm already 10% in. And overall, I think it's cute. Yes. So then on to whips. As I mentioned before, my biggest whip and my almost my oldest whip is my Fall Fairy. This is a design by Ruth Sanderson. God, I have a hard time to talk today. And it started by hate. It's a retired pattern, so you can't buy it anymore. But here it is. And I have been working, let me fold it a little bit, on this side. And I have done quite a bit, actually. how am I going to show this to you? I have stitched quite a bit in here, all the way to the side. Onto here, a little bit here. I have done about 4,000 stitches. So, yeah, this is it. Looks great, I must say. If I am allowed to say that about my own work. But I really love it, and I am still not sick and tired of working on this project. So. Then I started something new. I don't know if I have showed this in my latest video yet. But it's a yoke trebbenaai, so it's worth showing again. Let me see. Let me fold it a little bit. This is, let me show you the pattern first. Sorry about the creaking noises, but do I have a picture? of what it will look like. Yes. The spiral. If my camera will focus. Yes. The spiral. Bij Joker hebben de nijs. And I bought it last year when my husband and I were on in a weekend. Wait a second, my children are coming down. I'm sorry, I'm back again. My two children are sleeping up in the attic. I'm a little bit out of breath. They are both sleeping on the attic in we have something there that's called in Dutch bedstay. I don't know how you call it in English, but normally old houses would have them in the living room. They would have the bed, and it was like a closet. They could close it with doors in front of it. We have one upstairs, and they wanted to sleep there together. Of course, it's the weekend, so it's okay. But they were coming down that they needed an extra blanket, so I just gave them the blanket. So, here I am again. The spiral. this is how it will look like. And I stitched a little bit on this. This is a 40 count. Even weave. Is it focusing? Yes. And I'm stitching this in the color Passie, which is hand dyed by Joke Treppen de Nijs. And I should get back to this. I really do. I just made a small start for the acrostic. Then my second bag contains the Hello Pumpkin stitch along. Do I have a photo of what it will look like? No, I only have the pattern here, I'm sorry. But this was a stitch along by Caterpillar Cross Stitch, and I'm stitching this on a 14 count Ada with the Cold for DMCs. And this is on my Wipco board and on my acrostics. I'm trying to combine those two as much as I can. I also did that for Klein Paradijs by Joke Treppen de Nijs. And I'm also doing this, doing it for this one. I'm stitching 1,000 stitches for my Wipco board and 1,200 for the acrostic. So when I have finished 1,000 for my Wipco, I will continue to stitch for it on it for another 200 stitches. I have done about 250 stitches right now, and that's inside of this second pumpkin right here. And it's cute, it's adorable, and I love to see this grow. And that's that one. And then my latest one is also a new start. I'm all about the new starts this year. And this is December in the Netherlands by Twin Peak Primitives, which was a Dutch Mania exclusive. And I believe you can still buy it at the Handwerk Boutique. You can check out Annemiek her webshop, and I believe you can still buy it there. I bought this in remembrance of Dutch Mania, but also my children are both very small. They are 6 and 5 years old, so they still believe in Sinterklaas. And I think it's a magical story. It's similar to the normal Santa Claus, but a little bit different. I mean, our Santa Claus rides a horse on the rooftops, and he has little helpers to bring the presents around. And I think this pattern is so adorable. And when I am going to finish it, I'm really starting to like the way this is finished with the rickrack and stuff. But I want to see if there is a Dutch Sinterklaas fabric somewhere. So if someone knows about that, please leave me a message so I can order some of that to finish this. So I made a little start on it, and I have done this on a 16 count white Ada, which I hand dyed myself. And I really, really love how this turned out. And I made a little start on the border. And I'm stitching this in the Cold 4 DMCs. And don't you just love my needle minder? Isn't he cute? Little bee. It doesn't fit the Sinterklaas pattern at all, but I thought it was cute. I think it fits more spring patterns better, but okay. And this one is also for sale in my Etsy shop, so if you like it, then you can find it there. I will link my shop down in the description box. So, and this is also on my Corsix list. And that's it. It's not a lot. I've stitched some in December, but I was like, I'm doing a normal update from the 1st of January, so this is it. My second update will be around in about 2 weeks. I try to upload every 2 weeks, but I'm not going to pin myself on a day in the week, since I'm doing a lot of other stuff, helping a lot in my kids' school, and sometimes I don't feel like I don't feel like filming, and I just want to stitch. So I'm not going to pin myself onto a specific day. Well, I hope my fabric will come very soon, so I can start with my linen and threads stitch along for 2020. Still have to finish my 2019, but okay. yeah, I just continue like this. I like the way I am getting a hold on all of my projects, so yeah, I just hope to give you a nice update at the second time I'm filming this year. So well, this leaves me for now. This is the end of Floss Tube number 16, and I hope to see you soon, all again very soon. I'm not able to speak anymore, so take your time to stitch a little bit if you can, and I hope to see you again. Bye!